"Do you happen to know whatever became of the Tin Woodman and the Scarecrow?" he inquired. "They live in Oz yet," said the girl, "and are very important people."
"And the Cowardly Lion?"
"Oh, he lives there, too, with his friend the Hungry Tiger. And Billina is there, because she liked the place better than Kansas, and wouldn't go with me to Australia."
"I'm afraid I don't know the Hungry Tiger and Billina," said the Wizard, shaking his head.
"Is Billina a girl?"
"No, she's a yellow hen, and a great friend of mine. You're sure to like Billina when you know her," asserted Dorothy.
"Your friends sound like a menagerie," remarked Zeb uneasily. "Couldn't you wish me in some safer place than Oz?"
"Don't worry," replied the girl. "You'll just love the folks in Oz when you get acquainted. What time is it, Mr. Wizard?"
The little man looked at his watch, a big silver one that he carried in his vest pocket.
"Half past three," he said.
"Then we must wait for half an hour," she continued. "But it won't take long after that to carry us all to the Emerald City."
They sat silently thinking for a time. Then Jim suddenly asked,
"Are there any horses in Oz?"
"Only one," replied Dorothy, "and he's a sawhorse."
"A what?"
"A sawhorse. Princess Ozma once brought him to life with a witch powder when she was a boy."
"Was Ozma once a boy?" asked Zeb wonderingly.
"Yes, a wicked witch enchanted her, so she could not rule her kingdom. But she's a girl now, and the sweetest, loveliest girl in all the world."
"A sawhorse is a thing they saw boards on," remarked Jim with a sniff.
"It's not when it's alive," acknowledged the girl. "But this sawhorse can trot as fast as you can, Jim, and he's very wise, too."
"Pah! I'll race the miserable wooden donkey any day in the week,"
cried the cab horse. Dorothy did not reply to that. She felt that Jim would know more about the sawhorse later on.